Hello, Vineyard family. Mark Warner here, your friendly neighborhood pastor with a COVID-19 update. With the reopening of local businesses, the president's announcement, the recent news that the governor of Kansas has ceded control back to the counties, and Johnson County's subsequent recommendation that everyone continue to follow the Ad Astra plan, you might be wondering, when will Vineyard reopen its building? Well, like every institution, VCC is grappling with a number of questions and issues. For example, will we experience a larger wave of illness as people begin to regather? If we voluntarily follow the Ad Astra plan, which is the choice before us, how quickly will we be able to move through the phases? What practices need to be in place in order to protect our members before we gather? And how can we help protect the most vulnerable among us? You should know that there are three principles that continue to guide our thinking about reopening the church. First of all, the church is not a building. We are the people of God, whether we gather in a building or are compelled to meet online or in small groups. Remember, it was centuries before the early church met in buildings, especially designed for worship. But the church, the body and bride of Christ, worshiped God, shared the gospel, discipled new believers, baptized, taught the word, prayed for the sick, and cared for the poor for many, many years without the benefit of a church building. As I've said, the building may be closed, but the church is always open. Second, the church is called to love. So our decision to close the building in the first place had more to do with our desire to live out Jesus's second great commandment than anything else. When asked, "Teacher, which is the greatest commandment in the law?" Jesus replied, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. And the second is like it. Love your neighbor as yourself." Loving our neighbors as ourselves requires us to do what is best for the elderly, for the immunocompromised among us, for people with underlying health conditions, as well as the young, the healthy, and those with strong immune systems. And then third, church ministry must continue. That was our desire. Our building has been closed since March 17th, but the ministry of VCC has continued uninterrupted. Folks have expressed deep appreciation for our online worship services, our Wednesday worship gatherings, the continuation of small groups, the receiving of phone calls from our leaders and staff, and our ongoing ministry to children and youth. New folks have found us as a result of our online emphasis, and we're excited to welcome those folks to the family. The church is essential. We, together, are here to help, encourage, support, and pray for one another as a faithful, non-anxious presence, a recombobulation station in a discombobulated world. So let me be clear. No one wants to see the building open more than me. I long for the day when we can meet together again. This enforced isolation has been incredibly hard, especially for those who live alone, are on the front lines, or are out of work. We long to see each other face to face, to worship together, share the Lord's Supper, and gather with friends. But our eagerness to be together must be seasoned with patience. So when will Vineyard reopen? Presently, we've deliberately not set a target date for restarting in-person services. Instead, we'll continue to gather online while diligently researching, studying, and evaluating the input we've received from the CDC and the medical community. We'll also continue to stay in touch with our leaders at Vineyard USA, other pastors in our movement, and in our own community as well, seeking the wisest counsel possible as we plan for the reopening of the building and our long-awaited family reunion. Simply put, we're moving cautiously as pastors, elders, and leaders to protect the people we love. More personally, in a situation like this, I'd rather be criticized for moving too slowly than to risk putting people I love in jeopardy. Again, no one is more eager than I am to see VCC full of worshipers on a Sunday morning. I miss you something awful. Until then, we plan to resume our on-campus gatherings as soon as we can do so in a way that allows all of us to share in the fellowship that we've come to know and love. Please continue to pray that the Lord would give us His wisdom as we move forward, that He would direct us as we serve the most vulnerable among us, and that He would continue to build us into an authentic spiritual community full of grace and truth. God bless you.